can have only DNA sequences, all the whole DNA sequences, and it can have all the SNPs database. This database will have information about the single nucleotide polymorphisms only, and you will have omic. Omic is for diseases, this genetic disease related database. This is for all disease related genes, what are all the organism in which it is prevalent, all that will be present in omic. Genomic database. This is very important nowadays because a lot of whole genomes are sequenced, and these genomic databases like PIGR contains each organism and the whole genome sequences of it. So, but all contains just nucleotides only, no protein structures. And what is a protein database is, either it is directly you sequence the protein, like I said for mass spec, you sequence the protein using a mass spec and then submit it in the protein database. Generally available are UniProt. Previously there was two things, SwissProt and TREMBL. What is TREMBL? Is translated EMBL. Those are now conjugated to form this UniProt. UniProt is now universal, it contains all protein databases. And nucleotide databases, we have NCBI, three main things, NCBI, DDBJ, EMBL. This is from US, this is from Europe, and this is from Japan. And all these are, the NCBI has so many other protein and other entries also. You also have genomic entries here, but the nucleotide thing here is GenPack. Now these three are important nucleotide databases. Now coming to you want to search your sequences homologous to you have to know the difference between homologous, orthologous and paralogous. Homologous is similarity, it can be in other species or thing. Now what is an ortholog? Yes, the ortholog is by speciation, it is by speciation this particular gene will be here also, here also. This will suppose this is man, this is chimp. You will have this gene, same gene doing the same function here also, but at a different species level. That is orthologous genes. Now when it is a paralog, what is a paralog is, you will have a gene, you will have this gene duplicating into other gene to form a different function. What happens in evolution is, first the gene will be there, the same copy of it will be made again, and that copy will be mutated to form some other function. Like evolution, like we can say it is trying a new function each generation. So what happens is, you can't change a major function of this gene, then you will die. So you will have a copy of it that will make changes to check out the probabilities. So that may do have a different structure and function also depending on the mutation. So that is known as paralog. So paralog can be in the same species also, but it is of a different function, it doesn't have this sequence. That is a paralog. Now we do only homology search. Homology search is done by BLAST. Generally we use BLAST. What is this? This is a local alignment. This is a local alignment too. You were there for local alignment, global alignment, you know? Local alignment is like, what is local is a particular pattern in the whole sequence. It will search for the particular pattern in the whole gene or whole genome or sequence like that. Global alignment is from end to end sequencing. Here, even if this pattern is present in some other gene, it will find it and it will say, okay, this is a hit, this has it. But here it has to search from point to point and it should be similar. The disadvantages with the global alignment is, as I said in the morning, suppose it is ATTGCAT, same thing, but you will have T, G, C, A in the middle. So even if this sequence is A, T, C, A only, but this will get a hit here by filling in gaps. So it is not the exact match. You know, this global element is done for comparing, if you really want what is the percentage similarity between big genomes and all. Local element is generally for a reliable tool, and this is used by this database. What is in, you should, there will be lot of hits in the coming for BLAST. There will be a column and you have to put the data into it, like DNA sequence, it will give so many hits. And you will have hits, the selection is, it should be, it should have a low error value, E value similar to error value. It means that no, it, the data which this E value gives is not, it's reliable that much, like an error of this kind from some other species is not hit there. So E value should be very low for selecting that particular sequences from the whole help it gives, whole hit sequence. Then what else we saw? We saw about motifs. Motif is a part of a protein, but it is an the pattern is present in proteins of similar families. Like it can be a structural motif or it can be a functional motif, but that particular sequence, it may not be in the same neighboring order in the whole protein, but suppose 1, 2, 3. This 3 is here. Some other species also, this at this protein, the same sequences are there. So you call it a motif. It is an independent unit. This here, in this, this some other species, you can have any other amino acids in between. But this 3 are prominent, like in serine proteases, alkaline phosphatases. All those active sites amino acids are same. So similar to that is called a motif. For finding the structure of a protein, you can search for motifs and find what are all the structures.